What I'm most excited to tell you about is that my experiment in trying to convert this small space into a nursery for a certain type of native bee has worked. And it's been so much fun seeing that it's worked. So what's this native bee? It is called the small carpenter bee. And don't worry, it's not that big one you see buzzing around in your face that drills holes in your deck. This guy is way smaller, doesn't even look like that bigger bee. And what it can do is drill little holes in woody stems, like the coneflower. It's last year's stems. Let me walk over here. And they actually, each one of those stems has become a nursery for this little tiny bee. This was earlier in May. I also cut some stems of a shrub back there and a few other plants, and they're still doing it. There's new nurseries. Well, the first sign that you've been successful into converting your garden into a little bee nursery is when you see sawdust on your plant leaves like you're seeing now. You can see all the sprinklings of sawdust, and that's a sign, look above it, that there is a stem that these little bees are converting into a little nursery. And I had cut that stem a week ago, and this little bee's already drilled out the inner soft pith in the stem, and it goes all the way kind of down several inches and starts laying eggs and bringing in little bitty balls of pollen, and then makes a little wall with the sawdust and lays another egg, puts in pollen, etc., all the way up. And then she stands guard all night by inserting her little body near the top, and often you can see the little bee butt sticking out in the early morning. She stands guard over them so that the ants don't maraud the eggs, and then goes out and forages for more pollen once the eggs hatch.